This helicopter is a real flying fortress. It weighs as much as an Abrams tank, can even carry entire airplanes, and accidentally demolish half of the airfield buildings during landing. Meet the Mi-26 Halo, the largest, heaviest, and most capable helicopter in the world. In this episode, we'll talk about what this flying ship, built back in the USSR, is capable of, what weapons and equipment it carries, how much it can lift, and how it saved two US Army super heavy helicopters during the war in Afghanistan. And if you want to find out what the vehicles carried by a Mi-26 are capable of, you should try World of Tanks, sponsor of today's video. World of Tanks is a free-to-play online game that takes you to the captivating World of Tank battles. Over 800 armored vehicles, from light tanks to real artillery. Each of them is recreated with amazing historical accuracy. And most importantly, you can modify any vehicle according to your own preferences. There are more than 40 maps waiting just for you, from hot deserts to thick forests and city streets. The game is available on PC and is a lot of fun for inexperienced players who are only at the beginning of their path into the World of Tanks. Follow the link in description to download World of Tanks. Use the combat promo code to get a week of premium access, 250,000 credits, the premium tank Cromwell B, and 3 rental tanks for 10 battles each, Tiger 1-1, T-78, and Type 64. See you on a battlefield. So, in the early 70s, the USSR started a project to create a heavy military helicopter. The new model was to replace the previous Mi-6 and Mi-12 helicopters. It is worth noting that the latter was previously the largest helicopter in the world. Mi-12 could carry up to 88,000 pounds of cargo. It was tested in the 60s, and its main task was the transfer of heavy strategic nuclear missiles. However, in the 1960s, international tensions between the US and the USSR began to diffuse. In particular, the SALT I treaty was signed, which limited strategic weapons. This made the Mi-12 unclaimed and gave rise to the new, lighter Mi-6 helicopter. A few years after it, the Mi-26 came along. Interestingly, it surpassed the Mi-6 in payload capacity by a factor of 2. This is despite the fact that the fuselages of both choppers weighed the same. In the test, the helicopter was one of the most problem-free. Specialists almost immediately decided to put the Mi-26 in production. They were so confident in the development that by the time the tests were completed, all the equipment for its production was already prepared. Thus, in 1980, the Soviet Air Force was joined by the Mi-26 helicopter, which received the NATO code designation Halo. This H-47 Chinook helicopter can carry 55 soldiers or 26,000 pounds of cargo. The US Army's most capable helicopter, this H-53E Super Stallion, can carry the same number of soldiers or 35,000 pounds of cargo. The Mi-26 lifts 44,000 pounds of cargo, or hold a landing party of 82 soldiers. But its records don't end there. In 1982, it managed to lift a load of 55,000 pounds to an altitude of 13,000 feet, and in 1996 it accommodated 224 paratroopers, with whom it climbed to an altitude of 20,000 feet. Together with its cargo, the helicopter can weigh a maximum of 123,000 pounds. This is more than the weight of an Abrams M1 tank. The Mi-26 has been given a versatile design. It is built in such a way that it can be quickly converted from cargo to military or rescue transport. However, its primary mission is to carry heavy military equipment, both internally and externally. Its cargo bay measures 39 feet long and just under 10 feet wide and high. In troop movements, transport aircraft like the L-76 and N-22 carry cargo or troops to airfields, and from there, for delivery to remote and inaccessible places, they are carried by Mi-26s. They carry BMPs, BTRs, radars, armored vehicles, and artillery. There is enough space inside the Mi-26 to fit an entire Mi-24 fuselage. In addition, the helicopter is designed to carry 9 K-79 Tachka and earlier 2 K-6 Luna missile systems on a chassis of PT-76 tanks. During the Afghan War, the Mi-26 was part of the 23rd Air Regiment of the KGB Border Troops, which carried out combat missions. In addition, it participated in the elimination of the accident in Chernobyl in 1986. At the time, the helicopter was used to decontaminate contaminated areas. It dropped a mixture of boron, sand, and lead to extinguish the nuclear reaction and suppress the spread of radioactive dust. It has a huge number of the most unusual missions to its credit. The Mi-26 pulled the Douglas A-20 Havoc, a World War II bomber, out of the swamps of New Guinea. It airlifted a Tu-134 airplane, pulled a mammoth skeleton trapped in a block of ice from the ice of Siberia, and even helped the United States Army rescue two transport helicopters. During the war against the Taliban, two MH-47E Chinook helicopters broke down and got stuck in the mountains. Then, the United States, through private companies, asked Russia for help. For $300,000, a private company leased an Mi-26 to help pull out one of the helicopters. The second was not repairable, and it was not pulled out. 6 months later, another Chinook got stuck in the mountains of Afghanistan, and it was also pulled out by this steel giant. Today, the Mi-26 continues its work around the world. It has 13 modifications, and the total number is more than 300 copies produced. To date, it is the largest and most payload helicopter in the world, which will serve for decades to come. That's all for today. Thank you all for watching. Follow the link in description to download World of Tanks. Use the combat promo code to get a week of premium access, 250,000 credits, the premium tank Cromwell B, and 3 rental tanks for 10 battles each, Tiger 131, T-78, and Type 64. See you next week.